This call is now being recorded.
প্রপার ধরো গরম আছে।
হ্যালো, ক্যান ইউ হিয়ার মি অল?
ইয়েস ম্যাম,
হ্যালো,
ইয়েস ম্যাম।
ওকে, অল অফ ইউ প্লিজ স্টার্ট গিভিং ইউর অ্যাটেন্ডেন্স। ফার্স্ট গিভ ইউর অ্যাটেন্ডেন্স, ইউর নেম, রোল নাম্বার অ্যান্ড ইউর, লেট আদার্স জয়েন অ্যান্ড ইউ স্টার্ট গিভিং ইউর অ্যাটেন্ডেন্স ইন চ্যাট বক্স, ইউর নেম, রোল নাম্বার অ্যান্ড ইউর স্টুডে স্টাডি সেন্টার কোড। প্লিজ অল গিভ ইউর অ্যাটেন্ডেন্স।
Hello, ma'am. I'm Pinaki Goswami from Kuch Bihar.
Yes.
My enrollment number is 19789-5378.
Yes, you write it in chat box.
Yes, ma'am. Sorry.
You have to give your attendance in chat box.
Okay. Thank you.
Please all give your attendance in chat box. Once you give, then I will share my screen with pointers today. So I have seen here 18 people. So please all give your attendance fast.
Ma'am, I am trying to type in, but it is not being accepted in the chat box. I'm Pinaki Goswami from Kuch Bihar.
But others, attendance is coming.
Yes, but I am trying. I have tried for 3 or 4 times to type in.
Okay, you tell me one name, Pinaki Goswami.
Yes, I'm from Kuch Bihar. My enrollment number is 19789-5378.
1 second. You can view the chat box.
Yes, I can view it, and I have clicked also, but the typing cannot be done.
Is your chat box is enabled to chat? Something it is being disabled, then you can't chat. Okay, you repeat your enrollment number.
Enrollment number is 19789.
This is your first class or earlier you have joined?
No, ma'am. This is my first class.
19789 then?
5378 78 78.
I look. Bunny, bunny, Emma.
It's okay. It's only like that. Should we tomorrow back for good? I'm already kind of the other one. What an each other. What a Have you all given your attendance?
Yes, ma'am.
Have you all given your attendance in chat box?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, then I'm sharing the screen.
Yes,
ma'am.
Okay. Ma'am, just a minute. Ma'am, hello, ma'am. Hello? Ma'am, just a minute, ma'am. I was writing the enrollment number and somehow I have done the mistake, ma'am. I am typing in once again, ma'am.
Governor, who's crossed me up?
You retype. Ramana. You retype and give heading corrected enrollment number. You retype, okay. No issue. You give again and give your attendance again and retype. I'm sharing the screen.
Okay, ma'am.
See, actually I'm taking the class from card and so there may be some disturbance in network. So if the connection get lost, you please rejoin in the meeting, okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am.
Whoever entering the class now, please give your attendance in chat box. And already 10 minutes gone, please. Whoever is there in other centers, please join now. Because every time I cannot go back in the screen and let you enter.
Yes, ma'am, I have done.
All of you, please give your attendance. Is the screen visible to you?
Yes, ma'am.
The book of MCS 011 is being shown. Okay. The last day you requested
ma'am,
I cannot see, ma'am.
If any one of you cannot see, then it's a problem. But if someone of you can't see, then it is not my problem. It is your problem. Maybe from your side, maybe the connectivity be low. And if nobody can see remaining, that is not my problem. Okay. So you please check your network connections. That may be a problem. Otherwise, you all have your MCS-011 book PDF. All you have now.
Yes, ma'am.
From
yes,
any
yes,
other yes. screen, you open the book 3. Open book 3, chapter pointer. And I'm giving you the page. Yeah.
But the single cost money, right? Ramada Hotel.
So all of you requested last day that you require pointer to learn.
Yes, ma'am.
So can anyone define me what is pointer? In C you have covered this is C. Okay. So anyone from prior knowledge can define pointer? So pointer, you know, normal variables. Who are variables? Tell me.
Variables are, for holding data or operands.
Okay. Variables are, actual definition is, variables are temporary storage locations inside the memory. And if the normal variable, it only takes value. But some variables are there that only take, that don't only take the values, they also take the address of a variable. Why we need address? Because we know that any variable cannot stay without any address. Whenever we are declaring a temporary storage location inside the memory, then one area is allocated inside the memory, and that area is pointed by an address, and that address is stored by the pointer variable. So now tell me, what is the difference between normal variable and pointer variable?
Yes, ma'am. A normal variable will hold a data, but a pointer variable will hold a memory location.
Location, very good. Okay. So, can you tell me, is normal variable falls in the category of integer? Okay. But it is a signed integer. That means value should have either positive value or negative value, but address can never be negative. That means integers fall in the category of signed variables, and addresses fall in the category of unsigned variables. Means if you place variable and addresses in two category, then variables are assigned integers data type, and addresses are assigned unsigned integer data types. So have you any idea of signed integers and unsigned integers? Addresses are unsigned integers, values are signed integers. So what does it mean?
Ma'am, signed integers, the leading bit represents the sign of the whole number.
Yes, if variable variable have two types of variable can store positive numbers as well as negative numbers. So they are variables can store positive numbers and negative numbers. So they are signed integers, signed integers, and addresses contains only positive numbers, so they are unsigned integers. So for signed integers print, we use the percent d operator. For unsigned integer e print, we use the percent u operator. So whenever you are trying to print the pointer variable instead of normal variable, suppose normal variable is an integer, then you have to use percent d. If normal variable is a character, you have to use percent c. If normal variable is a float, you have to use percent f. If normal variable is a string, you have to use percent s. But for address, for addresses, you have to use percent u, because in this chapter, percent u will come.
मैम आपका आवाज ठीक से नहीं आ रहा है
मैम, वी आर नॉट गेटिंग यू. हेलो मैम,
हेलो मैम,
शी हैज ड्रॉप फ्रॉम द चैट.
वेयर शी हैज गॉन.
Hello, 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 anyone, hello. Anyone there?
Yes, you are audible, but ma'am has dropped from the chat. Maybe there's a problem with her connection.
Oh, yeah.
Who is from IGNU?
I think I lost the connection. Okay, so okay. Please, whoever have joined, please give your attendance. You are entering too late. It is not allowed. 7:30 class has started. So now you can see the program.
Yes, ma'am.
So,
yes, ma'am.
The actual size of you know. One integer contain how many bytes? One integer contain 2 bytes. Contain 4 bytes.
Ma'am.
One character contains 1 byte.
One byte.
So this program is it any problem in this program?
No, ma'am.
You can understood, no? Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Then we go for the next program. It is giving you the size. Now the first concept of pointer variables. Let us see the important feature of pointer variable. See, this is a picture. It is showing that the address of CH is contained by the pointer PTR2 and the address of number variable is contained by the pointer PTR1. These are the concept of pointer variable. Actually, this pointer variable is the variable. If it's point to some variable, then it explains that it containing the address of that variable. For the pointer, why we use the pointer in programming? The program execution time will be fast as the data is manipulated with the help of address directly. So execution time is fast because we are now playing with the actual address, not the data. We'll save the memory space. The memory access will be very efficient because actually you are actually accessing the memory, not the data. And dynamic allocation is possible with the help of pointer, which is not possible with the help of normal variable. So first, see the program here. So this is the main three allocations of pointer variable. See, what is written? Can anyone tell me what this program shows?
Ma'am, the address of the variable.
Yes. What is the normal variable declared? QTY. Its value is 5. But address is not declared. But it is automatically assigned because it lies in the definition of variable that once you declare one variable, its address is automatically allocated. So how can you fetch the address? By which operator we are fetching the address? Tell me.
Ampersand operator.
Ampersand operator. And by which formatting string we are using here for printing the address?
%U.
Very good. You can see here %U, ampersand QTY. Okay. And for placing the value, it is already known %DQTY. And what is this? Pointer ampersand QTY. What does it mean? It is
dereferencing the address to get the content.
Yes, actually, it is the value at the address of pointer. It is the value at address, value at the address operator. Actually, ampersand QTI means the address which is contained by QTY, and finally which is pointing to the value by this pointer operator. Ampersand QTY normally means the address which is contained QTY, that address. And pointer ampersand QTY means the value present in the address QTY.
No.
Hello. Okay, can you hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so pointer ampersand QTY. It is QTY is containing which address? 65524, which is the address of QTY. And the value contained in QTY is 5. What is contained in QTY? 5. Understood? Ei jagata ke bujhte parle na bolo. Ei jonno pointer ke value at the address operator bola hoy. A line term that is declared by this line, value at the address operator. Understood?
यस मैम
তাহলে একটা ফার্স্ট প্রোগ্রামিং এ চলে যাই পিটিআর ইজ দা ভ্যালু ইটস অ্যাড্রেস ইজ দিস ওয়ান PTR is containing the address of QTY and QTY is having variable value address. Okay. Here you tell me which is the normal variable and which is the pointer variable of PTR and QTY.
PTR is pointer.
It is containing the address of QTY. Okay. QTY. You understood. Next. So tell me, by ampersand QTY, what it will going to print?
The address of QTY.
PTR, by normal PTR?
Address of QTY.
It is also the address same thing.
PTR equals to ampersand QTY. Both of them will print the same. Because this assignment, it is the assignment. As PTR is a pointer variable and QTY is a normal variable, then the address of QTY is being declared, stored by PTR. Address of QTY is being stored by PTR. So QTY is the normal variable and PTR is the address variable. And so they are related by this ampersand operation. And if we are writing QTY and PTR, they will print the same. And if it is asking for ampersand PTR, then which value will be printed? Tell me. Which value will be printed?
Ma'am, this will print the address of PTR value.
So which one? Tell me. Now the screen is there.
5522.
Very good. Everybody understood? And what is the value of, now all of these are printing address. That's why we are using the formatting string %u. But once we are going to address, place the value of the variable, then we are using the formatting string %d. So %d PTR will give the value of PTR. %d QTY will give what? %d PTR, one second, no, %d PTR will print, one second. Value of PTR. Value of PTR is?
And this is the address of QTY.
One second, yes. There is some problem, I think. See, this is extra. See, this is not printed because this is correct. This line is not correct. This line is not correct because with PTR, PTR's value, it is an address. It cannot be printed by %d. This is a wrong one. That's why it's here. The six lines are there. Six outputs are there. This is a wrong line. You cut down. This is a wrong line. See QTY. QTY is what? QTY equals to value of QTY, which is 5. Pointer ampersand QTY, which is also 5. And instead of ampersand QTY, you replace it by PTR. It is also 5. So this line is wrong. Understood? Ei line ta bhul ache.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, keta dao eta. Next. Int pointer p. P is a pointer variable and pointer p equals to 10. The value of %d, comma pointer p, and the value of %u, comma p. This gives you an error. The pointer p is in uninitialized and points to a random location in memory when you declared it. A assignment are wrong. Int pointer p, a pointer to an integer. Pointer p is pointing to pointer p equals to 10. This pointer p is uninitialized and points to a random location in memory, 10. When you declare it, it could be pointing into the system stack or the global variable or into the program's code space or into the operating system when you say pointer p equals to 10. So this is a wrong assignment. The program will simply try to write a 10 to whatever random location p points to. The program may explode immediately. It may subtly corrupt data in another part of your program, and you may never realize it. So almost always an uninitialized pointer or a bad pointer address causes the fault. It is not a proper declaration of a pointer. One second. So what will be the correct declaration you see? When a variable declaration is there, a pointer variable can be initialized by assigning it to the address of another. This is the correct line. P equals to ampersand x. This is the correct initialization of a pointer. So int x, x is initialized to a value of 10. It is a comment. Int x, p equals to ampersand x, pointer p equals to 10. Let us write the complete program. Int pointer p. So p is a pointer variable. Int x. So x is a normal variable. Now the thing is that p equals to ampersand x. That means p is pointing to x. And pointer p equals to 10. That means that value of x equals to 10. Okay. Because pointer p means pointer in bracket ampersand x. That is equals to 10. So one, if you not write what is int x, then int pointer p, separately you have to take one normal variable, one pointer variable, then you have to relate them by assigning the address of the variable to the pointer, and finally pointer p equals to 10. That means that actually x equals to 10. Now if you clear write percent d comma pointer p, then it will give you the value. Again, it is wrong, I think, because here percent, as you were percent d is wrong here. It needed to be percent u, because the address will never be placed in a address integer variable. It has to print with a, if you try to print an address, always you have to use the address operator, then only it will be printed. Otherwise, percent dp, p equals to ampersand x, you just do it in the computer. If it is come, it is depend on compiler to compiler. Okay, suppose pointer p means value at the point p, so value at the point p is 10, and p is what? It is the address of p. Address of p is that it is the address of x. P means it is the address of x, so the address is being printed. So you please tell me that, do you have any confusion in this program? Then I go to the two applications of pointer, the call by value and call by reference, and the returning more than one value. These are the two main operations of pointers. Pointer to pointer, double pointer. It is an important one, because all the data structure programs start with this approach. What is pointer to pointer? Tell me, int I equals to 100, int pointer pi. Achha, any, all of you can hear me, na? Amake shunte pachho to shobai?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Dekheni abar recording hocche.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, okay. Ekhono joining cholche. Whoever entered it just now the class, please give your attendance right now. See, pointer pi, that means if I am writing, and pointer pii. So one pointer is pi, another pointer is pii, but it is a double pointer. Double pointer means a pointer variables is points to a normal variable. But if a pointer variable points to another pointer variable, and that pointer variable is points to the main normal variable, then it is a double pointer. To tell me how this is gone. Int pointer pi, int pointer pii. P PI is pointing to which variable? You tell me. PI is by this expression. PI equals to ampersand I. So PI is taking the address of which variable?
Ma'am,
address of I. PII is written as ampersand PI. So what does it mean? PII is taking the address of PI, the pointer. So PI is pointing to I and PII is pointing to PI. But at a whole, say, like grandfather, father and son, the grandfather is also connected to I. Through the grandfather, you can access the son. Through the father, you also can, through the grandfather, you can access the grandson, and through the father, you can access the son. So PI is connecting to PI and PII is connecting to PI, but this through this double pointer, PIII means actually it is I. Single pointer PI means actually it's been printing the value of I. So last time we have seen, we have, if I given %d pointer PI, then it will give the value of I. If I give now %d pointer PII, then also it will give the value of 100. Actually, PII is pointing to PI and PI is pointing to I. As a whole, PII is pointing to I. Understood? Now to the output.
Yes, ma'am.
Tomra nichera bolbe output. Thik ache? Egulo sob latest sheet. See, this portion already you have seen that int I equals to this int pointer PI relations given. So address of I. So whenever you are trying to printing an address, you have to give the formatting string percent u, and you have to give ampersand I. Ampersand I is how much it will be printed. It will print the actual address of I. Okay. If you give PI and ampersand I, will they print the same or not?
Same,
because why? See the relation. It is PI and PI equals to ampersand I, and both are printing the address. That's why you need an percent u operator. See the address of I, percent u. See now, pointer PII. Pointer PII means what? It is pointing to the value of whom? Single pointer PII. It is pointing to the value of whom? Buddhi kore bolo.
Then this is address of PI.
Pointer PII. It is the, actually PII is what? It is address of PI.
Yes,
so actually it is pointing to whom? PI. So it will not print the address of PI. It will print the value of PI. What is the value of PI? It is the address of I. Understood? So pointer PII will print the address of I. And ampersand PI. Ampersand PI is what? PII. So it will also print what? It will print ampersand PI. It will also print the value of PII.
Yes, PII.
See the values. See PI, address of I, it is this. Pointer PII, it is also address of ampersand I. Ampersand I. I er address koto boleche? 65524. Etai print holo tin bar. Karon what is ampersand I? That is PI, that is pointer PII. All are address of I. These are the different forms to present the int. Then PI. PI equals to ampersand PI. PI ampersand PI. PI PII. PII ampersand PII. Egulo ki ache? Address of PI. Address of PI means ampersand PI. Ampersand PI means what? Ki bolo? Address of ampersand PI ki press ki print korbe?
Ma'am, address of the pointer PI.
Pointer PI, that is printed 65522. Then what will be printed by PII? PII and ampersand PII are same. See here. Same to PII equals to ampersand PI. Is it same to? Same thing will be printed 65522. Now the thing is there. Now all the values will be printed. So first three values of I's are printed, then address of PI is printed, then same thing is printed. What is ampersand PII? This line, printf address of PII equals to percent u new line ampersand PII means the last address. Means the last address. Final means the address of PII. It is not the address of PI or not the address of I. It is the address of PII. Okay, so it is 20. Same is each integer. 20, 22, 22, 24, 24. So means PI and PII. See, 1 integer difference is 22 byte difference. See, now the values of I. See the values. It is easy. I means also value. Pointer ampersand I means what is the address of I? The value at that address. Pointer PI maneo 5 and pointer PII maneo 5. If in these four lines you have any doubt, you can ask me. Otherwise, I go to the next section. All this same thing. I equals to pointer and I equals to pointer PI equals to pointer PII. So pointer PII is the representation of I. Pointer PI is the representation of I. Pointer ampersand I is the representation of I. All of our values, so all our percent DS is print. See the thing. Now you can see. It is the actual thing. PII. It is the final variable. It is the double pointer. Its value is 6. Its address is 65520. That's why we got 65520 here. Its value is 65522. So, as the address of PII, we get the value 65522. Then PI. PI's address is 65522, but value is 65524, which is the address of I. So, in case of address of I, always we get 65524. So you check with this map, PII is point to PI, PI is point to PI, because PII contain the address of PI as its value, PI is contain the address of I as its value. So these are two pointer, but this is a normal variable because it contains only a value, no address. Understood? And I am going for null pointer assignment. Null pointer, if you want to use a pointer which is not going to point any address, then this is the null pointer assignment. Int pointer PI equals to null. And now if you try to put the PI whatever in PI, then output will be zero. Okay, output of the pointer will be zero.
Okay.
Some rules may sometimes come. You have only read out these rules that some rules are there for pointer. Pointers can be incremented or decremented to point to different location, like PTR1 equals to PTR2 plus 3. This is a valid statement. PTR plus plus, PTR minus minus, PTR. These are all valid statements. Two, if PTR1 and PTR2 are properly declared and initialized pointers, the following operations are valid. Okay. Res equals to res plus pointer PTR1. Pointer PTR1 equals to pointer PTR2 plus 5. Prod equals to pointer PTR1 into pointer PTR2. Q quotient equals to pointer. So you can multiply pointers, you can divide pointers, you can add pointers. Expressions like PTR1 equal to PTR2, PTR1 less than PTR3, not equals to, are permissible. Provided the pointers refer to same and related variables. These comparisons are common in handling arrays. Okay, now another thing, invalid. P1 equals to P1 plus P2, so addition of two pointers not valid. And P1 into P2 or P2 by P, multiplication or division of a pointer with a constant is not allowed. Multiplication or division of a pointer with a constant is not allowed. It is not constant, no. P2 by 5 are invalid. An invalid pointer reference occurs when a pointer's value is referenced even though the pointer doesn't point to a valid block. Suppose P and Q are two pointers. If we say P equal to Q, when Q is initialized, the pointer P will then become uninitialized as well. And any reference to pointer P is an invalid pointer reference. Now you can see the program. It is the two application of pointer. If I pass normal value inside the variable and pointer value inside the variables, then what is the difference? See, these are two functions, swap val and swap ref. Two variables are declared and initialized with 10 and 20 values. Now swap val, there are two swap val will occur on two variables, and swap ref is also occurred on two variables, two pointers. Now printf pass by value method. Before calling function swap val, x equals to %d, y equals to %d, comma x comma y. Okay, swap val x comma y. Printf after calling function swap val, x equals to %d, y equals to %d, x y. Printf pass by reference method. So what is this? First you have told that pass by value method. So you have called this two function. Once you have declared two function, now you write printf pass by value. Printf before calling function swap val, x equals to %d, y equals to %d, comma xy. Swap val xy. So it is the function. Printf after calling function swap val, x equals to %d, y equals to %d, xy. So this is the initial line will be printed. After this line, the swap val, x and y will swap their values regarding value. And after this statement, the swap values will be swapped according. So print after calling function swap val, this printf now pass by. Now this total thing will be repeated. See the first line, pass by value, it is pass by reference. Before calling function swap val, it is before calling function swap ref. It is swap val xy, it is swap ref. What is the difference between call by and call value parameters? Tell me, what is the difference of passing parameters in call by value and call by reference?
In call by value, we call the subroutine or the function using the value of the variable. And in call by reference, we pass the address of the variable.
So what we have passed in call by value, only the variable directly. But yes, what we have passed in the call by reference, by their address. We have here we have passed our values and here we have passed their address. So here the values will be 10 and 20 and here the addresses of x and y. So if you swap the values by call by values, then the change is not permanent. But if you swap the value using call by reference, then the change is permanent. How you can see this? See, these are, you know, everything that functions are called inside main and functions are declared inside main. Because see, we have not so many classes, and on your request after branching, we have direct and some explanations of arrays. I have directly come to pointers on your request. So functions already got missed. That much classes are not provided. So explain everything. On your request, I have started pointer, and in the next class, I will try to introduce file. So int x equals to 10, int y equals to 20, swap val function call declared, swap ref function declared. Here is declaration only int, it is int pointer. So this is the difference in declaration. Now the difference in call. This is the statement printed, then function will be called with call by values. And after calling, the new values will be printed by this line. Printf pass by reference method. Printf before calling function values are this. Swap ref and x and y. And after calling function, the values will be like that. So what has happened? void swapval, it will take two values from there. 10 and 20 will come here. So temp equals to 10, x will be vacated, x will have 20, y will be vacated, y will be temp. So x and y interchanged. Now printf within function swapval x percent d y equals to percent d x comma y. So they will print x equals to what they will print in this line. What they will print?
10 20
they will print.
Sorry ma'am, here we are after swapping, we got at first 20 and then 10
I think. Okay, now that is the thing. Okay, next. And here they also do the same. Here you are changing using pointer, because they are, instead of, as you have referred, as you have in the declaration section, you have called by the, you have declared as the pointer, you have called by the reference, and also you have follow the same method. You have declared pointer int pointer pointer now. So I have declared in pointer px in pointer py. Now the changes will be through them with a pointer temp. Instead of x, temp equals to pointer px equals to pointer py, and pointer py equals to temp. And percent d pointer px will print the same value of percent d pointer px pointer py will place the new value of x and y. Now see the changes. What is the output? So pass by value method, it is a long output, I think. Yes, pass by value method before calling function x10 y20, within function, which you have told me 20 10 change again. Once the calling has been done, the compiler come back here. Once you call here, it go back in the here. After declaring this statement, it come back to here, and after calling, see, once the compiler jump back from the local function to the global one, here it has printed 2010, but after again it goes back there, it present 1020, no final change. So 1020 in the main function, when compiler jumps to swapval function 2010, again when it go back to swapval main, it again proved 1020. But see, here the thing will be not there. See, here x equals to 10, y equals to 20, it is equals to 20, it is equals to 10, and it is equals to 20, it is equals to 10. The change is permanent. So this is the main application of pointer. If you are changing or swapping the value using normal variable, there will be no change. But if you are doing the same thing with the pointer variable, and by passing the reference, or passing the, instead of passing xy, you are presenting ampersand x, ampersand y, the changes will be done in the address, and the change will so it will be permanent. Okay, and finally another thing, that you know, generally what do you mean, function can function return more than one value? Tell me anyone. At a time, can a function return more than one value?
No ma'am.
Why not? Tell me, explain.
Because it depends on the return type of the function.
Very good. How, suppose we are suppose we are taking two variables. One is in a single calculated function, there are four things. Int d will contain c plus d, int e will contain c minus d, int suppose int pqrs. Pqrs are the return variables. Pqrs, p is contain the a plus b, q a minus b, r a into b, s a by b. If you in a once you one by one return, you cannot return the four values. You have to this way return, there you have to declare another four variables, return d. So return will return to that that variable where you have declared the function. So in a single, eta to function chapter er jinish, eta to ekhon bola jay na, mainly bole dicchi je যখনই আমরা কোনো ফাংশনকে উই আর ডিক্লেয়ারিং, we are also declaring a container variable, and if you are calling the function within that container variable, the value will be returned itself into the container variable. We have some function, and suppose that function will have some output. So if we try to place the output, that will not be placed, the print the output from the main, then in the main we have to declare some return another variable to contain the thing which are sent by back by the return variable, return statement. So we can use one return statement with one function, but with pointer, if you use pointer, you can return more than one value in a pointer. For a particular function, only one variable used normally to return the value. But for pointer variables, other things are also required. See. Float lane br, float peri ar, void peri, area peri, float length, float breadth, float pointer, enter the length and breadth of the rectangle. Scanf, %f, %f, ampersand lane, ampersand br. See, scanf, we have scanned the values of length and breadth. But in peri area, we have passed four variables. Length, br, and peri, and ar. And peri and ar, they are not given any value. And peri and ar, they are not given any value. So we are trying to... So once we call the function peri area, what the things we have passed? One length variable, one breadth variable, because for calculating the length and calculating the calculating the perimeter and calculating the area, we need these two variables. But printf, perimeter of the rectangle, comma peri, this is the result variable, and area of the rectangle is ar. These are two float variable, but we are not passing these two floats. Now all are floats. Lane and br are passed by values. Peri and ar are passed as reference. So you see what done in the application. So peri area is the function, and we are here. Now float length, float length, float breadth, float. It is ampersand, so you have to declare your pointer. It is also ampersand float. So float pointer area, perimeter. So pointer perimeter equals to 2 into length plus breadth, pointer area equals to length plus breadth. So this pointer perimeter, when you are declaring here, automatically they will go back to their container variable peri, container variable area. Okay, because here you use and peri and area. You know the real parameters and the formal parameters, you know the difference. What is the difference between real parameters and formal parameters,
ma'am? 2 into
lane and br and peri and ar, era key parameter, real parameter and a formal parameter. When we are calling the function, we pass the real parameters. When we are declaring the functions, we pass the formal parameters. Real and formal parameters need to be same, but sometimes you can change the names. If you also change the names, they also... So len give the value to length, br will give the value to breadth, and peri will pass the address to pointer peri. So pointer peri is... Perimeter is a variable, pointer variable, which is pointing to the variable peri. Area is a pointer variable which is pointing to the value of ar. So if you do any change in pointer perimeter and pointer area, automatically that will be scanned into the address of peri and area, and whenever you are going to print the peri and area ar, they will print the value. And here you see in a single function together you can return more than one value, which is not possible in normal function. Function with normal variables. Acha ekta kotha ami bole di, I am just going back to the screen now. I am giving you some time, you go back to the pointers, and if you have any query, we have our next class today itself. I am telling you one thing, I am coming back to the screen. See, actually, one second.